I came to this country when I was 6 months old. So I have very little recollections in that sense of Cuba, but I have since then built sort of my own repertoire of memories. So I feel an absolute connection to this place and the history that it narrates through its collections. Though my area has been the visual arts, it's through that lens that I have deepened my sense of history, of Cuban history. This position really encompasses a lot of my core interests. I've been at the CHC throughout many years, actually, in my academic career as a researcher, as a grad student, as a fellow. You know, the moment I walked in here, I felt a connection with the place. At the Cuban Heritage Collection is really one of the most remarkable accomplishments that the exile community has done, really, because it's a collection that has a history that sort of, to a large extent, mirrors the history of the exile community, if you will. So it's the vision of passionate women librarians who were pioneering in their field and had the vision of a place that, again, and against all odds, really built it from nothing. I am very keen on bringing that experience, on expanding the Cuban Heritage Collection's visibility through programming and through a curated approach. And what I mean by that is that programs that we develop here would support a central premise, a central idea, from which then, you know, other programs can emanate from, but always supporting and highlighting the strengths of the Cuban Heritage Collection. The work of the CHC is so important because of the legacy of a community, of a country, of a people, of a culture. And I think that story hasn't been told, you know, loud enough outside of the academic community. This goes back to my idea of an archive as a living entity. It's not just a repository where things are kept safely. I mean, that's a big part of it and a very important aspect of it. But again, how do you activate that to be continually relevant to future generations?